Hello everyone, welcome back to Electroblast triple line. In today's tutorial we will see the commutation in a DC generator. We know that the current or EMF induced in a DC generator is alternating in nature. So in order to convert this alternating current into a pulsating DC, we need a commutator. A commutator is a split ring made up of hard-drawn copper material which is used to convert a bidirectional current into a unidirection. I will repeat this point once again. A commutator is a split ring made up of hard-drawn copper material which is used to convert a bidirectional current into a unidirection. Also, we know that by Fleming's right hand rule, if we stretch our first three fingers of our right hand mutually perpendicular to each other, the forefinger points the direction of a magnetic field, our thumb represents the direction of motion of conductor, then our center finger points the direction of current. Now, in case of a DC generator, the magnetic field lines is from north pole to a south pole, and let the direction of rotation of conductor is clockwise. Therefore, the conductor under the influence of north pole, the direction is taken as upward, and the conductor under the influence of south pole, the direction is taken as downward. Therefore, by Fleming's right hand rule, the direction of current under the influence of north pole is inward, and the direction of current under the influence of south pole is outward. So from here we observe that when the conductors come out under the influence of north pole and enters under the influence of south pole, the direction of a current is reversed. So the process of reversal of current in a coil when it passes through MNA is known as commutation. I will repeat this point once again. The process of reversal of a current in a coil when it passes through MNA is known as commutation. And the time taken for the brush to span from one segment to the other is known as commutating time. If the current reverses completely within the commutating time, then the commutation is said to be a successful linear or ideal commutation. Under this condition, there is no sparking at the brushes and the current flows smoothly. And if the current does not reverse completely within the commutating time in a coil undergoing commutation, then the commutation is unsuccessful and is called as non-linear or a delayed commutation. Under this condition, there will be a sparking at the brushes which may damage the winding and brushes of the generator. Now, to understand commutation more briefly, let the winding assume to be a ring winding and the width of the brush is exactly equal to the width of the one commutator segment. I will repeat this point again. Let the winding assumed to be a ring winding and the width of brush is exactly equal to the width of one commutator segment. Also, consider a three coil, capital A, capital B and capital C, and a commutator segments small a, small b and small c as shown in a figure here. Now, to understand this, let us assume a five cases. Case 1, when a brush is in contact with the commutator segment B only. Let each coil has a 20 ampere of current Under this condition, the brush collects a 40 ampere of current, 20 ampere by coil B and 20 ampere by coil C. Now consider a case 2 when a brush just touches the commutator segment A. Now at this condition, the coil B is short circuited by the brushes and hence the current is reduced from 20 ampere to 10 ampere. I will repeat this point again. The coil B is short circuited by the brushes and hence the current is reduced from 20 ampere to 10 ampere. The amount of current flows through commutator segment A and commutator segment B depends upon the area of contact of the brushes with the commutator segment. We know that resistance R is equals to rho L over A. This implies resistance is inversely proportional to area. Also, resistance is inversely proportional to the current. This implies current is directly proportional to the area of contact. Therefore, the 30 ampere of current is flowing through a commutator segment B as the area of contact of commutator segment B with the brushes is more as compared to the commutator segment A, and therefore a 10 ampere of current is flowing through commutator segment A. And in this way, the brush collects a 40 ampere of current. Now consider a case 3. When the brush is equally in contact with the commutator segment A and B. At this condition, equal amount of current is flowing through both the commutator segments A and B as the area of contact with commutator segment A and B is equal. Also, the current in a coil B is equals to 0 ampere and therefore, a brush collects a 40 ampere of current, 20 ampere by coil A and 20 ampere by coil C. Consider a case 4th when the brush just touches the commutator segment B. At this condition, the current in a coil B increases from 0 ampere to 10 ampere but in a reverse direction. I will repeat this point again. At this condition, the current in coil B increases from 0 ampere to 10 ampere but in a reverse direction. And we already discussed in case 2, the amount of current depends upon the area of contact of brushes. Therefore, the 30 ampere of current is flowing through a commutator segment A and a 10 ampere of current is flowing through a commutator segment B as the area of contact of commutator segment A is more in contact with the brushes as compared to the area of contact of commutator segment B. And in this way, the brush collects a 40 ampere of current from a commutator segments A and B. Now, consider a last case when the brush is in contact with the commutator segment A only. Under this condition, if the commutation is successful, linear or ideal, that is, the current reverses completely within a commutating time, then there is no sparking at the brushes. And at this condition, the current through coil B increases from 10 ampere to 20 ampere. And the brush collects a 40 ampere of current, 20 ampere from coil A and 20 ampere from coil B. But this is not a practical case. Practically, the current does not reverse completely within the commutating time because of self-inductance of a coil undergoing commutation. I will repeat this point again. Practically, the current does not reverse completely within the commutating time because of the self-inductance of the coil undergoing commutation. And this induces a reactance voltage which is given by L multiplied by twice of armature current divided by commutation time, where L is inductance, IA is armature current, TC is commutation time. Now, at this condition, the current through coil B is not a 20 ampere current, but is less than 20 ampere current. Let the current through coil B is 15 ampere, and therefore the 35 ampere of current is flowing through a commutator segment A, and rest 5 ampere of current is flowing through commutator segment B, which jumps from commutator segment B to the trailing edge of the brushes in the form of sparking, which may cause damage to the winding and the brushes of the generator. Now, if we observe the above five cases, we find that the current through coil B first decreases from 20 ampere to 0 ampere and then increases from 0 ampere to 20 ampere in reverse direction in case of ideal commutation. In case of practical commutation, the current first decreases from 20 ampere to 0 ampere and then increases from 0 ampere to 15 ampere, but in reverse direction. This is our practical case. And this is our ideal case. Here we can say that the total current changes from 20 ampere to minus 20 ampere. In general, we can say that the total current changes from plus IA by A to minus IA by A. That's all about the commutation. I am winding up my lecture here. See you in the next one.